And sorry for the minor hitch. Internet connections, although in Bombay everybody says that it is all available, but there are issues. So any case, now we are set. As somebody else was asking earlier, I want to know how many people are using Evernote as of today. Very few. And how many people use OneNote? We have got Microsoft in majority. Okay, both Evernote and OneNote has similar advantages. One is stronger in one area, another is stronger in the other area. So first, let us look at what sort of a problem we have. As people who are in business, three mistakes we have of being productive. One major issue is addiction to stress. Every day when we wake up, we try wondering, aaj kya karna hai? What is there? We start with the stress. These are my deadlines, these are the deliveries, these are the points that I have to take care of, these are my suppliers whom I have to pay, etc., etc. So we are really, really addicted to stress. If you don't have stress, sometimes you feel vacant. There's nothing today. What do I do? Something must be there. You try to recall, and sometimes we even try to create stress. We are so much addicted to stress. The solution to that is you must build breaks after every portion of working. You must have breaks. Try to do that. Not many of us do it. Like the minute you are in your hot seat, then through the day you are totally stuck there, and you don't realize, sometimes you don't realize to eat, sometimes you don't realize that we have to take a glass of water every 1 hour. So build breaks into your daily schedule. 30 minutes every 2 hours. People have different ways. Somebody says every hour you take 15 minutes, every 2 hours you take 30 minutes, etc., etc. But important thing is we must include breaks in our daily schedule. That is number one. Number two is most important, not writing things down. A lot of times we try to remember, we sometimes feel that we are superhumans. And our brain is for collecting ideas. It is like a RAM. The minute something new comes up, the earlier one goes out. It is flushed out. That is how our brain works. And if you don't write some things down, like so many of us have this idea of one day I will go the spiritual way, one day I will do yoga every day. Some of you might be doing it, but a lot of people have this. One day I will do this. This is my passion. I want to do skydiving. Everybody has some thought or some passion, and it gets pushed out of the mind. The minute something new comes up, it gets pushed out. And we don't write it down. The minute we don't write it down, you tend to forget it forever. When the time comes, when you're 50 year old, you don't know, when you're 60 year old, time to retire, you realize, because now what? A lot of people want to get out of active business life and want to relax. And then they start remembering their dreams of 20s and 30s. So we don't write it down. Our mind is only for getting ideas. It is not for holding them. And the third important thing is we don't plan our work. We must spend at least 30 minutes every day in the morning to plan what we want to achieve today. And you must have all heard of this point about urgent but not important, important but not urgent. These are things which you always mentally decide. Again, you don't write it down. And therefore, when we don't plan our work, what happens is that we tend to miss out on some things which are important, and we tend to do some things which are urgent but which are not important. So important thing here is that we must plan our work once a day, once a week, once a month, once a year. Once a year also try to figure out where we are, what we need to achieve in the next 1 year, in the next 5 years. Once a day, of course, you want the immediate things to be taken care of. But planning is very important. What Evernote does is helps us in these two things, writing down and planning. And that is what any note-taking app will do. How many of us use a diary? All? And that diary is physical or?
Physical
or electronic? Physical. So what happens is there is a telephone call, somebody gives you a telephone number, you write it down somewhere, you scribble it on a chit, and then we don't know where that chit has gone. Happens? All the time it happens. Then you collect telephone numbers, and then what happens is that at the end of the year, you put it in the diary nicely. At the end of the year, you have to just copy it, everything. And then the time comes when it is too much for you to handle. So then people find different ways of how to carry it forward. There are tasks that you need to carry forward. There are telephone numbers which you need to carry forward. There are projects which you need to carry forward. So all these things becomes a big, big pain. And as usual, tech people are very lazy. They throw things here and there and forget where they have put what. So sometimes you have scribbled some important password on a piece of paper and that piece of paper is never available. Okay, these are all genuine issues. And how we use an electronic tool to handle all this is what we are going to talk about. Okay, how we are going to put it all together in one place so that it becomes easily usable. Before we go to the next slide, I want to run a small video which explains the problem to us.
When we are young, we tend not to interact much with the outside world. Our total list of responsibilities consists of stuff like clean your room, feed the dog, and be nice to your sister. But as we grow, some of the first demands of the outside world are placed upon us. Right around the start of high school, those demands dramatically increase as we make a wide range of commitments, including school, family, friends, relationships, sports, and other extracurricular activities. Add in the need to manage the email inbox, texts, and social networks, and we realize how we can start to feel overwhelmed and out of control very quickly. And as you no doubt already know, it only gets worse with time. Work projects, home improvement tasks, picking up the kids from camp, updating your will. There's a never-ending parade of obligations you make in life, both to yourself and to other people. Now, if you're like most folks, it feels like keeping up with it all ought to be a full-time job in and of itself. What if I told you there was a way to be more productive than you ever thought possible and enjoy amazing mental calm in the process, simply by taking all those obligations out of your imperfect brain and putting them into a trusted system instead? Best of all, it won't cost you anything beyond the will to change a few bad habits. But before we talk in detail about the secret weapon, let's talk about the coping methods most people employ and why they are woefully inadequate to handle all the stuff folks need to get done and keep straight. All this stuff tends to get funneled into four channels: your inbox, your to-do list, your brain, and in certain conspicuous places. Let's discuss these each in turn. First up, the inbox. The email client is, for many, the central hub of communication with family, friends, and colleagues. Typically, messages come into your inbox listed in chronological order. And there they sit. Some of it is junk, some is general reference, some you need to handle, and some have to wait before they can be acted on. The problem is that it's not immediately apparent from the list itself which is which. Rather than touching each message only once and then routing it to an appropriate place, people keep it all in their inbox, necessitating that they go over every message multiple times to make sure nothing falls through the cracks. Which, of course, it invariably does. Some people create multiple folders to help sort their obligations, but this often exacerbates the problem by multiplying the number of places you need to check for open loops. Next is the to-do list. Writing out a list of tasks is a good way to organize pending actions, at least in principle, because it gets them out of your head. The problem with many to-do lists is that they are grouped by one context, but can't be easily viewed from different contexts and points of view. We'll discuss this in more detail in the next video. Additionally, there are invariably things that don't get done on the day you plan them, and there results a disempowering habit of having to carry over unresolved tasks to the following day, and the next, etc. Now we come to your brain. This is a wonderful place for creating and working on ideas, but a terrible place for storing them, especially when action is required and those ideas turn into obligations. Getting stuff out of your head and into a trusted system is essential, at least if you want to avoid those oh crap moments where you literally shoot up in bed at 3 a.m. about that incredibly important task that should have been handled 2 days ago. When you can see everything on your plate at a glance, there's a sense of calm that results in knowing that what you're currently working on is exactly what you should be working on. With a secret weapon, that nagging voice in the back of your head can be silenced forever. Finally, we come to conspicuous places. Now, we all occasionally use this somewhat less obvious coping mechanism, where you place an object, like an important brief or a package to be mailed or the dry cleaning, in a conspicuous spot as a visual cue that you need to do something with it. While this system may actually function for, say, your car keys, it does not scale well and makes for a very cluttered desk or house. Best to get the action you are trying to remember written down, prioritized, and categorized instead. So, if the traditional system is failing most of us, let's describe the attributes of what we would want in the perfect task tracking system. First, it would combine all of the above methods into one place so that we can have one system from which to operate. Second, we should be able to group items together by more than one context simultaneously. Third, we want to have the system available and up to date regardless of our location or device. As we transition from home to work to travel, we need our system available to review, update, and fine-tune. Fourth, and maybe the most important, is that we need a way to capture ideas, to-dos, and new commitments as they come to us into a system that we know will be there later when we review it. The secret weapon is that system. Based on David Allen's getting things done approach, the secret weapon requires only two tools: the email client you already use, and Evernote, a web-based note storage application that's free, supports multiple platforms, and is insanely easy to use. In the next video, we will explore the concept of tagging a particular task with multiple contexts, and the power of being able to call up a group of tasks according to the project you're working on, how urgent the task is, where you are, or the people you're with. Stay tuned.
How many of us can relate to some of these problems? We can relate to some of these problems because today we are bombarded with so much of information from so many sources. You will get something from WhatsApp, and you will get something from SMS, and you will get something from mail, and you will get something, a good idea when you are traveling, and you will get a telephone call, and you will get an email. So how do you handle all this? And as you saw in the video, as we grow, our span of connectivity expands. When we are small, we hardly have any connections. And as we grow, the connections keep on multiplying. And the old connections remain. Suddenly, your school friends pop up and say, chalo, WhatsApp group for school friends. And your college friends pop up and say, WhatsApp group for college friends. And it goes on and on and on. You have the work group, and you have an ASIRT group, and you have a supplier group, and you have a customer group. And it goes on and on. So when we get information from multiple sources, the idea is to put all of it in one place, number one. Number two, it should be identifiable. So you have to organize it a little. You cannot be so lazy. You have to organize it a little, only at the first stage, so that you can find it easily when you need it. That is what Evernote is all about. And that is where we can end today. Yeah? So collect everything, put it in one place, organize it a little, and then see that you can retrieve it whenever you want it. Now things come to us from various places. Emails. Emails is one of the major mediums. How many of you receive letters now? Physical letters?
Only from banks.
Hardly. Hardly one gets letters. And how many of you even, I forgot what my letterhead looks like. Because we don't even use letterheads to send letters. Unless it is to a government authority once in a while. So emails is one of the primary modes of communication. We have emails, number one. Tasks come to us from multiple angles. From staff, from suppliers, from customers, and from the wife. There's no lady here. So I can't say husband. So a lot of tasks keep coming in. Suddenly she will ring up at 11 o'clock when you are busy with something. Remember to bring this home today evening. Or when you go to the chemist, pick this up. Very genuine. And it happens to all of us. Conversations, phone conversations, ideas, most important. Ideas can come to you anytime. At 11 o'clock in the night when you are trying to sleep, an idea might pop up and you want to jot it down. You will jot it down on a newspaper lying next to you, and the next day you don't know where that newspaper went. So idea is to collect all these in a single repository, regardless of origin and as and when they occur. That is most important. The originator may be anyone. The minute it hits you, you should know where to put it. That is the idea. And it should be as and when they occur. It is not that I will try and remember this tomorrow morning and it will be gone. Or something is to be done after 1 week, and you might miss out on that. How many of us use an electronic calendar? Which one?
Google
calendar. Because that is always synchronized with your mobile phone, and it is one of the best. So I would like to put all my tasks in Google calendar. So I will say something to be done tomorrow, phone call to be made. And then I don't make that phone call. How many of us carry it forward to the next day or next week? Or it happens. That person is not available, phone did not connect at that right time. And then you are busy with something else and it goes. And then we have to carry it forward. Sometimes it becomes difficult. Many times people do remember to carry it on, but it does. Now the second part of it, the organization part, is very, very important. We have to get out of this concept of files and folders. How do we organize our electronic material? It is always folders, subfolders, sub-subfolder, go down, 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 and ultimately it is a file. Okay? So it could be anything, and this is how we organize it. So if we are looking at a customer and we want to link that particular file also with the supplier, how can we do it? You will copy the same file in multiple places. That's the only way you can do it. There is no other way. What Evernote is most important, you have one object, and that object, you will see it in multiple scenarios, in multiple ways. So typically, whatever the object is, there are about four ways of looking at it, what we call as context. Who, that is the people associated with that particular object. What, that is the project itself, whether it is something to do or something to accomplish, or somebody is just to be called. When do you want to do it? And lastly, where is it to be done? A lot of times it is context based. Because Bombay is a large city, when we travel, we say, when I go to town, I must do this. Okay, so when I am in Nariman Point, I must meet this persons. Very difficult. You may think over the last 15 days that I must meet these people when I am in Nariman Point, but when you actually go there, you may miss out. So these are the various contexts. So what we do is, we try to tag each object. A tag is a new name as far as the normal Windows people are concerned. We try to put a tag on each object. So if I have a project, say, in Reserve Bank of India, and I have two people who are looking after it from my bank, say, and I have a friend who is helping me with that person, and I remember that every time I go to town, I must make a visit to Reserve Bank of India. I will put all those tags around the same object. The project is one, and I will put multiple tags to it. So I will see each object in a different way whenever I want to look at it. So when I'm looking at a person, I will see all the tags that are attached to other tasks which are for that person. When I'm looking at a location, I should be able to see all the tasks that I have for that location. And when I'm looking at a time, like when we say, like we are normally, now here the beauty of Evernote is you can do whatever you want to do. Tagging is up to you. How you want to tag. When I give you examples, I'll tell you how I do it. That doesn't mean that is the only way to do it. You can do it in whichever way you like. So when I say, when, so I have immediate is one. I put numbers to it. Immediate, later, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 is someday. As you said, some dream I have, someday I will do it. So I can put a tag of 5. Others are all 1, 2, 3, 4 are, 1 is immediate, that is I must do it today regardless of whatever happens. Number 2 is I might do it later, maybe during this week. 3 is within a month. 4 is maybe within the next 6 months. And 5 is sometime as and when I find the time or as and when I feel like it. So I might put numbers for when, where. Again, as I said, if I am going to town, I might have all the tags. So I put an at the rate sign. So at Nariman Point, at VT, at Andheri, whatever tags I want to put. And tag creation is totally open. There is no restriction on how we create tags. So I keep on one object, that is a task or a project, and I keep on giving tags to it. There can be n number of tags to the same item. So when I'm looking at a particular tag, I'm looking at all the things which are tagged with that particular tag. Are we clear? We'll see some examples. But this is what the basic difference between Evernote and our normal filing system is. Here I am getting rid of the filing system. I have to unlearn that, because I can drop anything anywhere and still tag it with the right things. And I can find it very easily. Of course, system is available, synchronized, regardless of location or device. This is another very, very powerful aspect of Evernote. How many devices do we have on an average? Everybody has 3, 4. You have your mobile, and you have your laptop, and you have your office computer, and you have your home computer, minimum. Then you might want to have a tablet also. Stuff like each device may be on a different platform. You may have a BlackBerry for your mobile. You may have an iPad for your tablet. And you may have a Windows computer sitting at. Regardless of device, I should be able to synchronize my tasks. And that is one very, very powerful feature which Evernote gives us. That it is irrelevant. Otherwise, if you have anything which is on iPhone and iPad, may not be compatible with Windows. And if you have something on Windows, may not go on BlackBerry and stuff like that. So here, Evernote is available on all platforms across the board. And that is another very, very powerful thing that happens. That regardless of location or device, location, of course, now with mobiles, you are totally independent of locations. You can be anywhere, and it should be synchronized. So the device has to be synchronized. But for the device to be synchronized, obviously, you need an internet connection. Without an internet connection, you are, but Evernote subverts that also to an extent. I'll explain to you later. So regardless of location or device, you should be synced. So you should be having the latest data. For example, when I'm working on this presentation, I was working from my home computer and my office computer. And then I have everything on my laptop. I don't have to worry. So kaun sa folder mein dala tha, pen drive leo, nikalo, push it from here to there, stuff like that. It is all there. Whether it is on my office computer, home computer, it is also on my mobile. So if my computer doesn't work just now, I can do the same presentation from my mobile. So it is available across the board. I don't care. Earlier, I used to, and this is a fact, that I used to carry something on my pen drive also and something on this thing. If it doesn't work here, then I have a backup. Now I don't have. Even if I get a net connection, I can run the entire presentation from the net connection also. I have no problem. Because Evernote is also available on the web. So if you don't have any device, and you are in a foreign country, and you remember this presentation or this address I want to find out, I can go to the web, evernote.com, log in with my user ID and password, and I can have my entire life there. There is nothing which I have to do further. So whether when it says regardless of device, I can say regardless of no device also. I just need a net connection, and that's it. I have to have, obviously, I have to have a secure connection, a fast connection, and I have, there has to be a password. Otherwise, it has no meaning. So regardless of location or device, I should be able to access my data, and I should have a powerful search. People have used search on Windows. Everybody has used search on Windows when you want to search something. You know how much time it takes, no? Sometimes it is scanning this drive, that drive. You include this drive, so searches will be faster, etc., etc. And we have all used Google. And we know how fast Google searches. Evernote almost searches as fast as Google. So the search function in Evernote is really, really great. So if you have organized your data, fine. You should be able to get what you want. But if you have not organized your data also, you should be able to have some keyword. Your keyword should not be the, which will be in all your notes. Some keyword which is unique to a particular note, and you should be able to look for it instantaneously, whatever your device. Are we clear up to now? This is a conceptual change. It's a shift in thinking. We are going to tag each and every item with tags which are going to be different contexts. You can change the context. You can define it whichever way you want. This is how I do it. And you should be able to search for it either with a keyword, or if you remember the note's name, then you can search it with the title. You can search it with a tag, whichever way you want it. You think this is doable? It is easy. Okay, one point in the video I forgot to mention is wrong, and that it says free. Everything is not free. Evernote has a graded model, so some portion of it is free, and then if you want the advanced features, which you will want once we understand those features, you have to pay for it. And you can try it free as long as you want. I tried it for about 2 years, until such time I realized that I need those features. And when you need those features, yeah, cost is not much. And I'm not selling Evernote. You can buy it directly online. They have now come up with 3 grades. I will discuss that also. The basic portion is free. The second portion is $45 per year. And the third portion is around $60 per year. So it's not a great deal. So don't get worried that I have to purchase something. You don't have to purchase anything. If you do it right on the first day, there's no problem. And if your data requirements are not very heavy, then also you are good enough. Now this, for OneNote users, this is all normal. The notes can be multimedia. Obviously, anything that can be stored on the computer can be stored on Evernote. So it could be a text, it could be a video file, it could be an audio file, it could be pictures, it could be anything. That is very standard. Whatever you can store on the computer, you can store it in Evernote. The searchability is the interesting part. You have optical character recognition inside PDFs and JPGs also. This is very important. So if you take a picture of something, say a news item, and you take a picture, because I said anything anywhere. So I read something in the morning during breakfast, I always sit with my phone. I feel this is interesting, I just take a picture. I should be able to search within the picture also. And that is what Evernote does. So searchability inside pictures, inside PDFs, inside attachments also. So if you have a note which has multiple attachments, something might be in Word, something might be in PDF, whatever the format, it will search inside all those also. So this is a very, very powerful feature of Evernote. Beyond this, I said I am free, so I can have a handwritten note also. It will search your handwriting also. Okay, so this is what power we get with the search. Of course, it is across devices. And one small feature which the paid version gives us is that you can have notes offline also. Typically, what happens is, over a period of time when you gather information, now information can be text, information can be files. Files can be large. And large files, how much can your computer store? Up to your hard disk size. How much can your mobile store? Much less. Right? You can't compare your mobile with your computer. So you can store thousands of MB on your computer, and on your mobile, obviously you can't store all that. So what Evernote does is, it gives you a summary, and as and when you look for something, it will fetch it from the net. It will hold it in the cloud. As and when you're looking for something, it will fetch it from the net. That's why an internet connection is a must. But take a scenario where you're traveling, and you are in a foreign country. And as you land, the net may or may not be available. Then what? You have lost your passport and your visa is on your Evernote. And you want to show him the visa. What happens then? The paid version allows you to have offline notebooks also. So at that time, obviously you will not dump everything onto the offline notebook, otherwise it will not be able to hold everything. So certain notebooks you can say, I want it offline, certain notebooks can be online. Most of the time it is online, but as I said, situations like this, or you move to a place where net is not available for whatever reason, it can be, the reason can be anything. So you can have an offline notebook also, where some important data, normally I would like to carry my PAN card, my Aadhaar card, all these offline. So I don't care whether my net is available or not, I should be able to pull it out and use it. And of course, we are talking of synchronization. Synchronization is very, very powerful. I don't have to do anything to synchronize. It does it automatically. I can define periods because I don't want to be disturbed every now and then. I can say every 30 minutes you synchronize, or every 5 minutes you synchronize. Or if you are doing something and last minute you are leaving, then you can manually synchronize also before you leave, so that you don't miss out the last portion. Now this fellow is doing synchronization. If you see from time to time, synchronization complete, that box will come here. So every 5 minutes, every 10 minutes, whatever period I have set, it will automatically synchronize. I don't have to do anything for it. So typical office situation, you don't do much. Only thing is, if you're doing something at the last minute and you feel that this you require next moment, then you will want to synchronize it before you move. So first step obviously is to download and install Evernote. Most people who have bought phones in the last 2 years have got it by default. And many people tell me, yes, I have it, but I don't know what it is, so I've never used it. If you have bought an Android phone in the last 2 years, Evernote comes installed by default. It is always there. And you can download Evernote from evernote.com, and you can install it on your computer also. And you can install it on any other device. On the Google Play Store, you'll have it. On the Apple Store also, you have it. So you can just download it and install it. Create a unique user ID and password. Your email is your user ID, and you create your unique password, because that is the basic thing without which you will not be able to access. And that is the basic thing based on which the system will identify it is you. And nobody else should be able to see your data. And the entire thing is cloud-based. And obviously, there is a default notebook. Now, there is a concept of notes and notebooks. Notebooks are like your folders, file folders. So you can have a folder and you can have a subfolder. So you can have a notebook and you can have a sub-notebook. But Evernote, for some strange reason, allows you only 256 notebooks. There is no limit to the number of notes. There is no limit to the number of tags. So even if you have only one notebook, you can store all your data, because your tagging has to be proper. Your notebook can be only one. But normally, as I said, you have offline and online notebooks. So to distinguish that, you can separate notebooks. So maybe maximum 10, 20 notebooks you may have. Rest of it is you are going to drive it by the tagging system. So notebooks are like your basic containers. They are like your folders, okay? And notes is what you dump into each folder. Now, one notebook can have n number of folders. One notebook can have n number of notes, and each note can have n number of tags. So when you're looking for something, it is very simple. But when you're storing something, you can store it in maybe 5 notebooks, 10 notebooks at a time. That is what I would recommend. Because then everything is there. I have a notebook called Cabinet. Cabinet has everything. By default, all my notes go into something called Pending. So Pending, everything is there. I don't have to worry. So let's see now how the main screen looks like. Okay, as I was saying, this is the presentation that I put, the presentation that you are seeing now, is in this notebook. I have written Evernote ASIRT. It is in my pending note tag and Evernote tag and in presentations tag. So I can look at it whichever way I like. I want to look for presentations, I'll get all my presentations in one shot. I want to look for Evernote, maybe I collect a lot of information on Evernote from various places. So everything about Evernote will be there. And I can look for multiple tags also. I can look for Evernote plus presentations, in which case I can see both this combined. So let's see if I make a new note. Very simple, neat and clean. I give it a title. I have my default notebook, which is pending. I can add tags and hazard other formatting options I have. Like I can use a certain font and I can use the size of the font and bold, etc., strike through. Code block, if you are writing code, if it's a computer code program, you can write it in a code block. Then you have your, you have a task list, checkboxes, and then indenting and aligning, and you can insert a table, insert a line, insert an attachment. Attachment means I can drop any file into this note. Okay, so if I have a Word file, so if, typically what happens is if I have a Word file and I want to put it there, I will just drop it in this. I can drag and drop, or I can say attachment. Normal way how you make an attachment in a mail. You just say attachment, search through your folders on your computer, and you can just select it, or you can just drag and drop. From wherever you are, you can just drag and drop. So I can type whatever I want to type. I can add tags. Now tags are dynamic in the sense if it does not find a tag, it will automatically create. So you don't have to go and say create this tag, create that tag, etc. But whatever you do, you should do it consistently. Suppose you have got a tag called hotels. Then call it hotels only. Don't call it hotels sometimes and hotels sometimes. Okay, so decide whatever is comfortable. You decide what you want to do and use the same tag, because otherwise there will be no consistency. Otherwise some part of it will be in singular hotel and some part of it will be in plural hotels. So whatever tags you want, because this is free form, you can write whatever you want to write. There is no restriction here. So I can create any tags here. Within the note, as I said, if I want to put attachments, I can just go to my file folders, pick up anything, any item, drag it and drop it into the note, number one. Or I can say attachments and add an attachment. I can say attach a file, my entire folder list is coming up and I can attach anything. The limit to attachments is 100 MB. Otherwise, synchronization becomes an issue. But I have never found that limitation. So I can type whatever I want to type in this note.
And can we attach Google Drive file also?
Yeah, Google Drive file will be on your hard disk. So you can drag it and drop it here.
But like it's on cloud also.
It is on cloud, but normally when you synchronize it, it is there on your hard disk. But in the new version, just now there is an upgrade, it's a beta upgrade. In the new version, online, that possibility is there. So then it does not block your Evernote data, it directly gives a link to the file in Google. Normally what happens is, when you attach anything here, that gets synchronized, and your data is taken care of. In the sense, if you have a 100 MB limit, it will have a 100 MB limit. There is a limit for the free version. You can upload only a 60 MB in a month, the free version. So So then that will occupy. But if you are using a Google Drive file, it will just take a link. You can even put a link here straight away. Google Drive allows you to copy a link. So that link you can just paste it here. That's good enough. You can run it directly from there also. You don't have to dial and then copy it here, etc. Just give the link here and that should be good enough. So you have your formatting options, tables. Tables I'm not very happy with, but it is there. It works, it automatically reformats based on your size of the text. Not very happy with tables. Checkbox is important because when you do ticking, sometimes in search from the phone, it allows you to search incomplete items. So all those which are not ticked, it will search. So checkbox is useful from that point of view. Now the same thing, whatever you can do here, I can do from my mobile also. Now how do I add a paper document? Obviously I have to take a photograph. So I use my mobile, I click and it gets attached there. Now you know how difficult it is if the paper goes into two pages or three pages. Suppose there is a minutes of the meeting. And I want to take three pages. Every time I take a photograph, it becomes one file. In Evernote, it takes it automatically one after the other. You can go on clicking one after the other and it will go on accepting those photographs and take it as a separate files, but one note. It becomes one note. So in one note, you can go on taking photographs of multiple pages. Attachments is simple. Audio, you have two options. We will just go through these one by one. Audio, you have two options. You can actually have an audio file. Means as I'm speaking, I can record it. And then that recording, I can put directly into the system. Second option is, I can record and say that I'm giving a dictation. So it will convert it to text and store it. So both options are there. I just don't want the voice to be recorded. Are you getting the difference between the two? One is the actual voice file is recorded. Second is I dictate and it will convert it to text and it will show me on the note. Accuracy is as much as what Google Voice also gives you. I would not say 100%, but it is pretty good. We'll try it just now. So we have voice and dictation. We have pictures and we have videos, obviously. Pictures and videos are straight away files. So it could be on your hard disk already or you could be taking it from your phone. So let me try something interesting. See what I'm doing. I'm starting Evernote. I am saying add a note. You saw what happened when we said add a note in the computer. Now I'm saying add a note. He's giving me all these options here. What do you want to add? Speech to text, or an audio note, or a camera, attachment, handwriting, or text note. Text note is the simple thing that we saw earlier. But now I will say speech to text. This is a great way of taking notes. That's why I need good connectivity, otherwise it doesn't work. Because it has to go to the cloud, convert. Here I'm not getting the connectivity. I'll try once more. This is a great way of taking notes. Now, if you notice two, three things which happen when you're taking notes also. Okay, it's not going to the cloud because this connectivity on top, this is not going through the Wi-Fi, it's going through this thing and the signal is pretty poor. It says note from ASIRT program, because in my Google calendar, I've got ASIRT program here. So he knows where I am just now. He also knows if my location is on, he also knows where I am in Vilepale East. It will know that. Here he is saying only at Mumbai, but there is a search option where I can say, this note, where have I taken? I'll say within 1 kilometer of this location, I should be able to search that also. Now that is how powerful the search is, which I have not seen anywhere else. Sometimes you link certain things with locations. I was in Delhi last week, I took notes there. So I might say, look for a note which I made in Delhi. Now here, this fellow is automatically tracking my location. Note from ASIRT program, Evernote at Mumbai, Maharashtra. Where I am? Where I am?
It's showing, it's getting recorded. Whatever you are seeing, it is recorded.
Speech to text is in the paid version, yeah. I think free version also has it. I'll show you the features. I'll show you the features which are the second number. Obviously, if you try to save a blank note, it will say your data is not saved. Let me try. Sorry? It's not in. No, you may not see the link because there is a way on which you can configure this also. What you should see here is configurable. Now, Parle International, okay, tell me. It works well. I must tell you, it works well. It is not. And if you have been using Google text to speech, it is as good as that. Which one? Second one? Again, coming to this one. I did okay. I am also not sure. 8430. I think we use the second one. I think so, yeah. Yeah, it looks like it is. Because my net, this signal is very, very poor. But let's see. I think this is a very good way of taking notes. No, sorry. Any case, take my word for it. It works well. Audio is just a recording. Whatever you record, it will just store it as an audio file. It requires good internet, yeah. Because text to speech, he always takes help from the cloud. It is not inbuilt. Camera. Now, camera is something interesting. What would you expect if I take, this is, I do all the time, I don't collect cards. I hate to store cards. How many of you store cards? when you get cards, suppose you are in a meeting like this and you exchange cards, and then where do you put them? Scan it. So I'll use my camera. This guy identifies this as a card. Oh wow. Then it goes to LinkedIn and finds out if this fellow is already on LinkedIn or not. And then he analyzes the card. I have not even clicked the camera. I have just pointed it to the card. This is the latest update in Android. This is very, very recent. Just 2 days back, I got it. Okay? So it scans the card. It puts everything in its position. I can say save. I can say add to my directory, and it will add to my directory also. It adds to the contacts. Sorry? Evernote feature. No, latest version of Evernote. They give you upgrades. So 2 days back, I got this upgrade, and I read about it. Sorry? I'm not too sure. But see how the card is looking. See how the card is looking, and see how it has analyzed the entire thing. Obviously, your card has to be in a neat and clean way. Some cards have very fancy fonts and all, which it will not be able to recognize. But if it is in cards which are standard format, it recognizes it very, very well, extremely well. And if I have a LinkedIn account, and if he has a LinkedIn account, I can add this fellow as my contact directly. So then I throw away this card, I give it back to the person who gives it to me on the spot. Okay, so I won't save it. So here I can have another, I can add one more card. See, the card is still sitting there. I can accept it or I can reject it. So I'll just reject it, discard. Now, again, I take another card. I'm just pointing. See, the square is automatically moving and trying to analyze. And my hand is shaking. Again, this goes back to the internet, obviously, because if you want to find whether he's on LinkedIn or not. Slightly, this is misspelled. I feel that this is... See the quality of the card. It is very, very tiny. But still, it has been able to capture. If the card is of standard font and size, normally you will be able to get it. So even if you get 50% of your cards, you should be happy. The other cards, you can just take a normal photograph and store it. Okay? See, now when you are having in your contact list more than 3,000, 4,000 contacts, then your contact list also becomes a little slow. Have you noticed that on your Google also? When you're on the cloud, on your net, and you go to contacts, it takes time to load it. What I do nowadays, every contact I don't call every day. Okay? So all the cards which I don't want to contact on a daily basis, I take them in Evernote. And the remaining contacts, I keep it in Google. Whatever I want to call on a daily basis. And here, I can always search for the name. Because when I'm taking a scan of this card, when I'm taking a picture, the name I can type and I can search. That is not an issue. Okay, so what I do is, I have got a notebook called cards, and I've got a tag called cards. And in that notebook, I keep loading all my cards. So sometimes the cards are haphazardly written. Sometimes on the card itself, somebody will scratch his email address and put in hand. Sometimes he will put his telephone number by, "Anare, mera number change ho gaya." You know, all these sort of things happen. So what happens is, so I have a notebook called cards, and here all my cards are stored. Now see, somebody, I have written this, email address was not there on this card. So I have written this by hand. I have just taken the picture. I don't store cards in my office at all. My card index is all gone. I don't need to, because everything I have and everything is available to me on my mobile.
So the lawyer is written by hand.
Sorry?
The lawyer term is written by, you have mentioned
advocate. Yeah.
No, the lawyer is on the left side.
Which one? Yeah, I have written. This is my title of the note. Lawyer. So if I'm looking for lawyers, I'll get all lawyers in one place. And I put so many tags. It is in my cards notebook. The tag is card. My Zoroastrian Bank elections related work I had done with her. I can add a tag as lawyer also. That is also a sensible way of doing it. I don't have too many lawyers to deal with. So if I have a sizable number, then I create a tag. Otherwise, I just search for a lawyer, and all my lawyers, all my advocates will come in one place. See, the search is beautiful. When I search, we'll see, the search is really beautiful. So I do it randomly. Like, if I want to add a tag called lawyer, I can always do it.
You can add more than one tag?
I can have n number of tags. I can have 20 tags to a particular note. There is no limitation. No, in this case, I did not have this recognition of the card. As I said, this has come just now. So I had just taken a picture. See, in camera mode also, I will show you. In camera mode also, when I go here, I have two options. What he is normally understanding, one sec, I'll show you one more item in camera, which is really interesting. Now, this is not a visiting card, but I want this article. It's an interesting article. So I'll go to camera. It is shining, but it's okay. So it has identified. I'm not tapping anything or I'm not clicking any picture or anything. Huh? It has taken it. Now there was a shine on this because it's a glossy paper. So you have to take care of the lighting conditions, obviously. But now when I say okay, the entire newsletter is cleaned and put up. And the text in this newsletter will be searchable. That is the beauty of the whole thing. So if I go here, now see, I can read it as clearly as possible. So this is, I was supposed to go for a walk just now, so it says walk at Mumbai. Okay, so now this is, here this small icon here means it is yet to be synchronized. It will be synchronized on its own. That is not an issue. Now this is one way of taking snapshots from the camera, and that is, it understands that there is a text document, whether it's a visiting card. Here it didn't try to attempt to go to LinkedIn and all that. It understands that this is not a visiting card, this is text. And I want to add multiple pages on this. If I want to take the entire newsletter, I go on taking pictures there, and I can go on adding. But now, if I add another item, suppose I want to take your photograph, obviously it is not text. So there is a icon on the top here, which says I can change the mode of the camera. Here it is just trying to figure out. You see the small square that is popping up, the rectangle. Now I'll say I don't want this. So now it is a manual mode. Now I can take a picture, and that is also good enough. Yeah? So you can save it as a photo, and all your other photos will be, you can save it as a business card. Suppose he has misread it, then you can save it as a business card, you can save it as a photo, you can save it as a document, or you can save it as a post-it note. They have a link with post-it, So the post-it color coding automatically is recognized by Evernote. So if I say all my office notes are in pink, then I just say look for pink notes and I'll give all my pink notes. All my home notes are in yellow. So post-it by 3M, they have a link with them. Evernote, sorry? So I can say save and that's it. Okay, and I can write, so along with the visiting card, I can take a photograph and I can save it in my notes. It is, you want to break here or? Just 2 minutes before we, okay, so I took this photograph. You saw this photograph, it is already synced now. I double click on it. Now you can see this, no? It's now when I see this note, I want to highlight something on this. First, what is interesting in this? Sorry, this. Okay, so now I have some information here which I want to highlight. I can highlight it or I can use a smaller pen and underline it. Somebody is really desperate. So I have different sizes, I have different colors. Okay. And on this side, we have various options here. You can append, you can replace. This is the link I'm using. On the top, you see A, that is for annotate. You can annotate any image. Okay, so I'm just clicking on A. And now I've got, now these are the options that I have. I can blur things. The first option is blur. So if I want to highlight something, I can blur things around it and highlight only one portion. I can put a stamp. So I can put a stamp like this, put a chapa here, which I can move around. Or I can draw a line or I can take a highlighter. Or I can write some text. I can say this is very important. And I can save it. So I am working on the image and making it more useful for myself. I'm highlighting something. I'm writing something, or I can put an arrow. Yeah. So when I am using something, and if I want to highlight something here, I should be able to do it. Na? Ali image leke, I got so much text to read. Now what was important in this, I don't know. So I should be able to do it. Here I can even do these things. I can draw a circle or a square or a, so maybe I can say, so I should be able to annotate an image. Okay? Useful? So when I take a picture is not a dead thing. Number one, it is searchable. I can search inside it. I can make all these annotations. And I can make it much, much, so next time I see it, I know what I have to see in this. I don't have to again start reading and find out, arre, boss, isme kya tha? I think we'll break here.
But guys, please be back in 10 minutes.
Hello. Can I please call everybody to their seats? Arvind, can you please ask everybody to take your seats? Wait for the next 60 seconds before we get on with the program. Thank you so much. Please cooperate with us. For quite a long time, though I do use OneNote, but I never knew these features even existed in Evernote. So something that really can make my life very easy. Even I can start throwing out visiting cards. All right, so I'd like to invite Mr. Tantra to take on with the next part of his session. Thank you so much.
Come back. The biggest gift I expect by doing these sessions, or I get overjoyed when I receive feedback from participants about how Evernote has changed their lives. I had one lady participant, she was a very senior person. She was a librarian at one medical library. And she made Evernote a part of her life, and she says, you have changed my life. Because for librarians, you can imagine that each book will have several tags. And if I want to look for a book with a certain topic or with a certain word, I should be able to find it. And within a year, she again sent me, actually every birthday, she sends me a happy birthday gift. And she sends me a snapshot of what she's doing on Evernote. And I feel overjoyed. So I expect that even if our people, even if 10 people can use it, there is a little bit of learning in this. But this session is only to show you the starting point. Then you are on your own. Then you can keep working on it the way you want it, because there are no limitations. The limitation is only our imagination. How you want to use it. So my request is that first 1 month, I was also finding it a little difficult to understand, to adjust. But afterwards, I went so deep into it that I cannot get out of it. Because the important thing is, you don't have an export function from Evernote. So you can't export stuff from Evernote to anywhere else. Your life is entirely linked to Evernote. Import is there. I think import from OneNote or something, options are there. But export is a little difficult. Then the site which I mentioned, that first video which we saw, thesecretweapon.org. Go to that site. There are lots of videos after that also. I showed you only the first introductory video. That is where I learned originally. One Sunday I was a little free and I went into one video and the second video, and then I didn't know what time it was. Very, very nice videos. It will give you some starting point. Ultimately, it is up to you how you use it, to modify it to the extent you want. Okay, so where were we? So we were just talking of populating the notes. How you populate notes. By video, picture, we talked about annotate. How we could annotate each note. In any picture, we can annotate. Evernote had a small software called Sketch, which now they have built into Evernote. So I am not talking about Sketch, because that was used for annotating earlier. And that could be downloaded by anyone. Even if you are not an Evernote user, you could just pick up any picture and start. But now they have discontinued. They have made it a part of Evernote. So pictures, videos, dictation, etc., etc. We saw the visiting cards and annotation and pictures. Another interesting thing that they have introduced recently is you can put a color to the note. When you're creating a new note, or even an existing note for that matter, just right click. We'll come to the other options. Sorry? There's something called style which they have added. Here? Yeah? No. Even the tags and all, you see I have n number of tags. Whichever tags are at, they are locations. Whichever tags are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, they are time. These are people and projects. And as you will see, I have hardly 10, 15 notebooks. Sorry? Okay. Now, there are certain other interesting things which you can do with a note. There is a reminder. People were asking me just now, so I'll take it up. This on top there, there is one small alarm clock. So I can set a reminder. So I can say add a date. Date and time I can set. Date and time for the reminder. And in the settings, there is an option that I want the reminders to come to me once in a day in the early morning as an email. So it can come to me as an email or it can pop up either on the computer or on the mobile at the date and time. The other beautiful thing about notes is you can share a note. Each note has a unique URL. So you can copy that URL and send it to anyone. After sending it, if you make changes to the note, it will be reflected in there. Now this is very, very useful. We conducted elections for the Bombay Parsi Panchayat and we had these FAQs for the elections. So we published them. The URL is very longish. So what we did is we used bit.ly and converted it to a short name. So you said bit.ly.com/FAQs. Now anytime anybody clicks on that, they will see the latest version of FAQs which is there on my Evernote. Now that is very powerful because virtually you are making a website and you are dynamically changing it. Suppose somebody says, "Arey, I forgot this point." Okay, add it. And next moment it is available to everyone who is This is the power of using the URL. So you can say copy or share URL. So what it will say is it will just copy it to the clipboard. And then you can use that URL in your email. You can use it, like if you see my clipboard, it is there. www.evernote.com and then a longish, funny looking link. Any case, it doesn't matter to the person receiving it. He has to just click on it. Or you can convert it into a brief bit.ly. You can use Google. You can use whatever you want to use and convert it. Now, the minute I change anything in this note and you have that URL and you click on it, you will get the latest version of the note. Now, this can be useful for even communicating with employees. Suppose you are doing a project and you have some steps. And you want to add or delete or you want to tick off, this is done, this is done, this is done. Everybody has the same URL. So if they click on it, they'll get the latest version of the project.
Will it also make changes then?
That again depends on if they are using Evernote and if you are giving them permissions. Yes.
No, but by the way, if they have access to the page without Evernote, they can't change the page.
Obviously, it is not in my interest. It is not in the interest of the creator. Obviously, I want to present something, so it is not that collaborative as maybe Google Docs. It is not meant to be. It is only meant to share. So I can share a link, social, I can post an entire note to Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn straight away from here. If I have those accounts, I can directly publish from here. So I don't have to just copy and paste and all that. I can straight away post to, send a copy of the note, so I can send an email directly from here to a particular address. Subject line will be the title of the note. CC me on this mail if you want, and write a small this thing, and the copy of the note will go there. Simple? And here you have this modify sharing, where you can enable a public link. So anybody with the link can view it. This is what you do normally for publishing it as a web page. And then you have this option here down below, modify individual permissions for this note. There you can give each individual permission to change the note if they want. And it will be reflected in both the notebooks. This note is not shared with anyone. If you have shared it with someone, then you can modify permissions. Somebody can only read, somebody can edit, and so on. Yeah, this answers your question?
Yeah.
This is important. The other interesting thing in the paid version, don't think that I'm pushing you to the paid version, but the other interesting thing in the paid version is every note has a small icon called information. Now here it gives you an entire history of this note. What are the tags, which notebook it belongs to, when was it updated, what is the URL, you can set a location, you can set an author, last edited, attachment status, and view history. What view history does is when you make changes to the note, every version of that note is kept in history. So when you make 10 changes to a note, you will have 10 versions of the note, because what you changed when, what time, what date, all will be recorded. Now this is the beauty of this. Now, of course, this is just an email, so there is no version. Maybe this one may have a version. So when I say view history, it shows me when all I had changed this. Wednesday, May 11th. And Tuesday, May 10th, April 29th, November 12th, it goes in ascending order. It was created on October 28, 2015, at what time? And if I click on anyone, it will show me the state of the note at that point of time. So if I'm making changes, I know ki kabhi kya change kiya. Otherwise, you are overwriting all the time. Your latest note is visible to you. So if you have a dispute or if you have something like issues and somebody says, I did not see it. Okay, at that point of time, what the note looked like, I can see it. So I can click on any of these and say import, and it will import it as a separate note and show me what exactly it was. Again, this is very interesting. Because when I make changes, sorry, here you have this small icon I, note info. Okay, so when you say note info and view history, when you say view history, you can share entire notebooks with other people. Like when my son went abroad, I had collected all his information in passport and visa and this and that and all. I shared it with him, so he has one version, I have the copy of that. So I can share entire notebooks also. So that is not an issue at all when you share notebooks. There is a presentation mode. So this entire presentation that you have, if you organize it properly, page by page, you can do a presentation directly. You don't need PowerPoint. So when you say present, yeah, and your cursor moves like this, you want to highlight something or, and you want to have a night mode, and you can have a night mode. Of course, I have not organized this as a presentation, but if you organize it as a presentation, you can do one below the other. Each slide can come as, this is mainly for local presentations within the office and all. If you want to make quick presentations, you share the notes and you can make a presentation. So that finishes this area of the, we saw how we could assign tags, any tag to any note, any number of tags. There is no limitation on that. Okay, so I am not getting more into this. Now the next thing is search. How do I search notes? Search, there are three ways of doing a search. One is our traditional system, which is still in our mind, by files and folders. And that is, if I have a notebook, I know which notebook, so I go to that notebook and I look into it, and I can look at it. Second is by tags, or by multiple tags. I can give multiple tags and I can search all notes which have all these three tags. Or third is, being very lazy, I can just search by the keyword. Okay, so when I come here, this is the option to search on top. Left. Okay, it says viewing 1334 notes in pending. But I can select any tag from here and I can search the notes, or I can say I want to search in all notebooks, or I want to search only in cards, wherever I want to search. Now I'm searching in all notebooks. Now I am the most laziest person on earth. So I want to search for a text called tender. There was a handwritten note which also it has got. You see my handwriting? Very horrible. So if you are making notes, suppose somebody is giving you his telephone number, you write down his name and you write down his number, and then you search for the name, you should be, in all probability, be able to find it. You saw this power of searching handwritten notes. Now, here I wanted to show you something interesting. This was a handwritten note. Now, this is a photograph. Usme bhi tender hai. And this is a Shopper Stop receipt where there is something called cash tendered or something like that. That also is getting total tender. It normally highlights. I don't know why it's not highlighting just now. I wanted to show you something very interesting because it is horrible. In the sense, the photograph is horrible, but it catches it very, very easily. You know, from the Times Classified, you know how tiny that font is. And I had to take a photograph from here to cover that entire thing. You know the small columns. and it is reading within that also. So the search is very, very powerful within. Now, the other beauty is, okay, we'll come to that little later, okay. First, it recognizes written text also. Most important point to note is it recognizes written text also. So handwritten text also can be read very easily. Advanced search, everybody knows how to do an advanced search. You put a plus sign or minus sign to include or exclude certain things. An exact phrase, if you put it in quotes, just like your Google search, you put it in quotes and you can search. Or you want to search in a particular notebook only, you say notebook colon and write the name of the notebook, you can get the notebook. If you are to search a title, you remember the title of the note. You can say in title colon, you can write the text in the title. This is interesting. Created colon. So I created this note 1 month ago. So I can say created colon month minus one. It will start searching all notes created. You can put a tag and say tag is so and so and created colon is month minus one. So last month with this tag, what note I have created. So date wise also you can search. Save searches was available, like certain things you want to search again and again. So you can save a search, but now it is disabled when the upgrade has come. They say that we will be reinstalling it little later. So sorting your search, of course, chronologically or date-wise or tag-wise or notebook-wise or whichever way you want to sort your search. And on the mobile, we have other searches. Like I said, there is an option where you can say, search all notes created 1 kilometer from this location. That is also possible. Email integration. We said, na, everything should go into one. Mera email kahan se jayega? Abhi tak toh we have just created a note and we have... So how do I have email integration? Email from Evernote we saw. Share karenge toh you can send an email directly from Evernote. That is fine. How do I send? How do I send email to Evernote? As soon as you create an Evernote account, it assigns a unique email ID to you, which is only for Evernote. Okay? That you will see in the options here. Tools, account info. And there is one email notes to so-and-so at m.evernote.com. This is a very funny looking address. You put it in your address book as an email address for Evernote. So you just call it Evernote. So whenever you send notes to Evernote, it should go to this address. Automatically it comes and populates your Evernote as a note. That email will be pushed automatically to Evernote. Are we clear on this? So if you are using, for example, if you are using Gmail and I want to push this note to Evernote, I'll just say forward to, in the to column, I will just say Evernote. So it will have that funny address here. I just say this and I say send, it will go to Evernote as a note. This is again very powerful, because when I am saying that everything should come in one place, there are connectors available for Outlook also. I will show you the connector available for Gmail also. There are connectors available for Outlook also. But this is a very simple way of forwarding a note, and it will be pushed to your Evernote. But then which notebook will it go to? It will go to my default notebook. But I want it to go to a certain notebook and I also want it to be tagged with something. Obviously, I'm a lazy fellow. I will not go again to the to Evernote and then change the tags and change the, this thing. So what happens is, in the subject line, you say at and then write the notebook name, put a hash and write the tag name. So automatically it will go to that notebook with that tag and populate it Evernote straight away. So subject line must have at notebook name and at hash tag name. And if I put an exclamation mark and put a date after that, it will set a reminder for this note also on that date and time. Now this is very interesting. So I am using my email system to push things into Evernote without manually. Otherwise, simple thing is copy and paste into Evernote. That is a very simple way of doing it. But here what I'm doing is I'm automating the entire process. I'm using the email client to send note to my Evernote address directly. So I'm setting the notebook, I'm setting the tags, and I'm setting the reminders. All three things I'm doing. So if my email subject says 5th year celebration, exclamation 2013/06/24 at events hash anniversary. What it means is, remind me on 24th of June 2013, this note should go to anniversary events notebook and anniversary tag. So in my subject line only, I will add these things and it will go to the right place automatically. If the tag is not there, it will be blank without a tag. It will create. I'm not too sure about that. Because when it gets transmitted, it is not interacting with the system, it is just populating. I'm not too sure about that. But normally you would want those tags to be there. Now this is the antique way. I am still more lazy. So there is an extension in Chrome and Firefox which is called the Evernote Web Clipper. Okay? What it does is, this note, or this mail, I want to ship it. Okay? I'll just delete this. I received this mail and I want to send it to Evernote. So if you see on the top here, I have got one elephant here. This is an extension which I have installed in Chrome. Now if I click on it, see the fun. Now he has identified that this is an email, first of all. Organize it. So he is saying, either you want the full email to go, or you want only this snapshot of what is on the screen to go. Those options are there, either email or snapshot. I want to organize it, so I will select which notebook I want it to go to, and I will add a tag here. Simple. I don't have to remember hash hai ki exclamation hai ya whatever. So I'll say I want to add a tag of say cards. So all my tags, when I say CA, so all my cards, all my tags with CA comes, I say cards. I can add multiple tags. I can add a remark. Now understand that Evernote is pulling all this from my Evernote. Because tags, how will Gmail know what are my tags? So my Evernote is going to Evernote, picking up all my tags, picking up all my notes, notebooks, and displaying them here. And then I can write any remarks if I want to add any remarks. And there are other options also, if I want to put a reminder, blah, 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 blah. Here it is, a whole lot of things. And then I just say save, and it will save it to Evernote. So sending a mail from here to Evernote is very simple. I just click on this, and I do it a lot of times. It is very convenient. I just push stuff to Evernote. directly from your web clipper. Now the web clipper is also very interesting in many, many other ways. I just showed you how the mail can be pushed. But I'm doing some research, so I'm visiting so many websites. Obviously, how do you capture all the websites into your bookmarks? Who uses bookmarks? Very few people use. Nobody uses virtually. Bookmarks can get very confusing after some time. Okay, so what I do is you have to organize it, and it's a painful thing. If you are doing a huge research on a certain topic and you want to pick up things, or why research? Otherwise also, you see something interesting on health, or you see something interesting on recreation. You want to save it in Evernote. What we said originally, everything has to go to Evernote. Right? So I go to a site called rediff.com. I go to news. Say I like this article, lifestyle tips. Now when I go to any site, whether it's a news site or anything, I see a lot of stuff on this site. All those flashy things and all the jazz. Do you want to read that or you want to read the article? I want to read the article. So I go to my web clipper. Now he's showing me a simplified article. See, I am getting all the options. I want the full page, I want to use this as a bookmark, I want to use a screenshot, I want a full article or a simplified article. Simplified article cleans up the article around it. All those flashy stuff is gone. I want to read only this, na? I am not interested in the ads, which distract me. And sometimes I can go from where to where. This I want to push to Evernote. Again, the same options. I can select my notebook. I can select my tags. I can say health. I can put a remark. What is good, what is not good, whatever I want to say. And I say save. It will go directly to my Evernote account. But there's more to it. Again, if I come here and I want to highlight something, arey yaar, ye important hai. So I can highlight this, and this highlighted text will go into my Evernote, not the original. So I am making changes to somebody else's website, cleaning it up, highlighting stuff, and then pushing it to Evernote. Really, really powerful. And I say save, it will go into my Evernote and sit in my health. And then you get back to the normal. The minute you save it, you go back to normal. Okay, it says here, 5 amazing reasons, clip to pending. So it is in my pending notebook. This is really powerful. This you can't do on your mobile, because mobile doesn't support extensions. Chrome in mobile does not support extensions. But on your desktop, and you can pick up various things from here and there. You can just take a snapshot of only this portion. Suppose you want only the image. Whatever you want to do, you can do. And you can push it straight to Evernote. It understands. See how it understood it was a mail. If you go to YouTube, it will understand it's a YouTube video. And it will automatically take it. So whatever you are doing, when you are online, you want to clip something, you can directly push it to your Evernote notebook. And it will go instantly. If I go here, this note should come. And this is how it has come with the highlighting that we did. Very powerful. I use this very, very often. Because now everything, whether it is a note which I have taken, voice, image, picture, video, anything. And now I'm clipping from the web also.
From OneNote, what are the major difference in OneNote and
SQL? It is another big topic by itself. I'm not getting into that because there are diehard OneNote fans and I am a diehard Evernote fan, so I may go wrong emotionally. Now I'm searching something in Google. So I'm searching for some tenders. What will you expect? All my notes which has the word tender in it. So if I'm looking for some product or service, I'm also linking my notes to my Google search, including the text. Write a note with tender, I just made a handwritten text. It has searched that and it has displayed. Obviously, the top three will be shown. You don't have much space here. Again, very powerful. Because if you are looking for something which you have already done and it's already part of your notes, this is that classified which I had taken. This, the long strip which has tender written in it. Extremely powerful.
Is it there in the basic version?
I'll show you the differences. A lot of things are in the paid version only, I agree. But once you start using the basic version, you feel comfortable, then you are always free to go to the paid version. Do you find this interesting? How that integration is done. Now Evernote has an entire ecosystem around it. Lots of people have built products around it. For example, when I talked about capturing data from by taking a photograph. Okay. Now suppose I've got a stack of 20 papers. So I am not going to sit and tap, 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 tap. So there is a Fujitsu scanner which is available. It is specially made for Evernote. So you put the stack there, 10 pages, 1 minute, it pushes everything into Evernote automatically. There's an entire ecosystem built around it. 3M makes slips, these are post-it strips only for Evernote, where you can search based on color. So I feel this is something very interesting and very powerful. Again, if you use IFTT, how many of you use IFTT? If this, then that. There is a program called IFTT where it comes as a app also on your phone. If this, then that, it is called. If you go there, there are lots of recipes. If you push a calendar item in Gmail, it should go to Evernote. That sort of a thing. If you put some note in Evernote with a certain keyword, it should go to X or Y, to-doist. If you are using to-do lists, there is something called to-doist. It can get pushed automatically too. So Evernote, there is an entire ecosystem. If you go to YouTube and just look for Evernote, there are hundreds and hundreds of videos which you can go through and learn something, and if you find something interesting, you can apply it to your own organization. Auto forwarding. In Gmail, we saw the use of filters. So suppose you have a weekly report coming to you every week from some location, and there is a standard subject line. So if you find that subject line, you use the Evernote email address and push it directly to that. You don't have to do anything also. Height of laziness. So weekly report you get on Monday morning, and you get Pune branch report dated so and so, so and so, so and so. So you say in the subject line, Gmail filters we saw last time, Anybody remembers? So there you see that in the address line, you say push it to Evernote. I have my Evernote email address. You say push it there with my exclamation and all that which I want to put. I can push it to a certain notebook with a certain tag. It's possible. So I can automate a whole lot of stuff. So company reports, etc., which come regularly, I can push it into Evernote. Or I can put anything which comes to me at regular intervals from a particular person or with a particular subject line, I can create a filter, push it directly to Evernote. Now, some more tips. I have to keep track of time. Table of contents you can make automatically. How do you make a table of contents? Little difficult, no? So what I will do is I will search all notes with a tag called health. Yeah? So these are all my notes on health. Breathing and doctors are this. I want to make a table of contents. So what I'll do is I'll select multiple notes. All these notes have come in one. 7 notes selected. I can say create table of contents note. So it will give me a table of, with the title of each note, it will give me a table of contents. Very smart. Okay, then I can do a whole lot of other things, like I can merge the notes, I can move it to another notebook, and I can do a presentation with that, whatever. Create table of contents note. Click it. There is a separate node which is created actually. While I am creating this, why it is not creating? No, tagged with health means it has to come here on top. You can click on each and with the title of each note. The title will show this is the note, and you click on the title and it goes to that note.
That's what I wanted to
say. Yeah. It does it very efficiently. I don't know why it's not. Presentations we saw, drag a note to toolbar for shortcuts, like notes which you use most often. What you can do is you can drag it to the toolbar and create a shortcut. So then you don't even have to search. Like on top you will see Evernote, presentation, trades, some address. I just drag that note to the toolbar and it becomes like my shortcut to that note. I don't have to do a search. So notes which I use most often, I go directly out there. Local notebooks. Somebody was asking me a question about security. I have everything on the cloud. What if somebody reads? And my privacy is compromised. So as long as you have articles and all, no problem. But if you have a credit card number, I don't want it to reside on the cloud. So when I create a notebook, it asks me, do you want to create a local notebook or do you want to create a notebook in the cloud? Local notebook will not be synchronized. It will remain only in your computer. Okay? A shared notebook means a synchronized notebook will be across all your devices. But a local notebook will reside only in your local machine. So that is one level of security. The other level of security is, suppose you are creating a note. And you are typing something. And you have a credit card number. And I say was ये तो किसी को दिखना नहीं मांगता है. इवन इफ ही हैज माय पासवर्ड और एवरनोट गाय वांट्स टू सी इट, ही कैन सी इट. सो आई विल से राइट क्लिक हियर, देयर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड एनक्रिप्ट सिलेक्टेड टेक्स्ट, देन आई कैन गिव अ पासवर्ड एंड दैट टेक्स्ट विल बी सीन एज स्टार्स ओनली, नोबडी कैन रीड इट एक्सेप्ट यू. इफ यू गिव योर पासवर्ड यू कैन सी इट. सॉरी, मोबाइल में राइट क्लिक एंड ऑल इज, but here you can do it and then in mobile it will be, you can again very very interesting in terms of security. I can encrypt parts of it, but the only limitation is that you can have only one password for your entire Evernote, because multiple passwords then storing and holding it becomes a little bit of an issue. Yeah,
can we make a daily to-do list or an appointment schedule?
Yeah.
Using audio to text.
Yeah.
So you just say okay, 4 o'clock I need to meet somebody.
Yeah.
And it comes in your calendar.
Yeah, it comes in your calendar. Meaning, if you have used IFTT, then it can be pushed directly to your calendar. You have to use. Are we clear of this?
Yeah.
Choose an encryption paraphrase, a passphrase. And you can even enter a hint to help you remember the password. So if you forget your password, you can enter a hint. You enter it once, you enter it twice, and then you have a hint question. So your security is taken care of. Sharing, we saw all these options, email, Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, email from Evernote to Evernote, info we saw, how we can see the information of each note, reminders we saw. This is the big slide. What is free and what is not? Basic, plus and premium, there are three versions. Basic is free, plus is costing around $35 or $45, and premium is costing $59 per annum. And these are the limitations. Not 60,000, it is only 6,000. Don't worry. $59-$60 is not a very big deal according to me. If you are getting all the features and you are using it. Okay, so this is a very simple chart. You will find it on the Evernote website also. What is free and what is not. Usage, as we said, usage can be whatever, daily, research, web pages, somebody wants to do cooking, somebody wants to do projects, library, whatever, you name it. Like, imagination is your only constraint. There is absolutely no constraint. And the final limitations, maximum 250 notebooks, no limits to number of notes or tags. Even in the free version, there is no limit. Only thing is the upload limit is there, so it restricts you to an extent. Free version, it gives you only 64 MB per month. Paid version gives you 200 MB plus per month. But I have never even gone to 64, honestly, even with the paid version. But I am using it more for the other features rather than the limit for upload. And there is no upper limit. Is every month if you upload 200 MB in the paid version, in a year, how much will you upload? 2.4 GB. And that, for 10 years, it will be 240 GB, and there is no issue. So storage-wise, there is no issue. Only per month storage is a limitation. That's it. If you have any questions, please. I think I made it in time. With Google Keep. Google Keep is very mischievous, I would say.
What if I have a lot of notes on Google Keep?
Google Keep is has a lot of problems with interoperability. Actually, if you see in Evernote, if you go to any, like I'm reading an article from a news magazine, every day it sends me one article. I'll show you one, if you want, I can show you to you. And I can, if I say share on your phone, then share me, you have 100 options. Share with this, share with that, share with this. But Evernote will get priority. And most of the time, it will come as a top, on top, it will come as a banner directly. You can click on it and you can save things in Evernote straight away. Interoperability, Google Keep is a little messy. It doesn't allow you to. Google Keep is a very good for basics and one at a time. Means it is only today's thing or only tomorrow's thing is fine. But Google Keep is not very efficient in terms of all these. Yeah. It is just like, yeah. It's a note keeper, but it's a very basic note keeper. So if you are not going to use any of the features, then Google Keep is the best. So there are 1,000 note keeping options.
And any questions, guys?
Any questions if you have, please. Sorry, where are you seeing it? Work chat, huh? Not chat. Okay. Work chat. There is another version of Evernote available as a Evernote for business. So virtually you can create a chat between two people or between five people and messages can flow from one person to the other. That is costing something like $12 per month per user, which is a little steep according to me. Image? Crop is not there, no. But if you have to crop an image, normally what I use is cam scanner. I use cam scanner on my phone, crop the image and then push it to Evernote. That is a very easy and even cam scanner, I don't know how many of you use it. But cam scanner is very efficient in terms of stabilizing an image, even tilting, it does a great job. And I enjoy it. That's one of my favorites also. So I push it from cam scanner into Evernote and it works beautifully.
Guys, it was amazing and power packed.
Sorry. Local notes can be saved on mobile also? Local notes, no. It will be saved only on your machine because it is not synced. If it is not synced to the cloud, it cannot come to your mobile.
No. As you said, local notes can be saved on the desktop.
No, there are two things. One is a note which is local only. Second is a note which is accessible offline. Note which is accessible offline can come to your mobile. But a local note will never come. It will not go from your local machine, in simple terms. So if you have a local note at home and you have a local note in office, both will be independent. They will remain there only. They will never be synchronized.
Can this be synced to CRM?
Yes. Salesforce and all, I think they are able to sync it. But as I said, like the resources are numerous, absolutely numerous. You'll go crazy if you try to find Evernote and find this thing. They are tremendous.
So suppose somebody wanted to use this for just because that topic came up, Salesforce management and things like that. And if you wanted to bring in task management coupled with this, so many features that you showed. Suppose I wanted to assign some tasks with my
There are so many task managers, yes. Like as I mentioned, something like to-doist is one task manager which is very popular.
Yes.
I don't know if anybody is using it. But if you are using to-doist, there are certain keywords if you put in this and you synchronize with to-doist, it will go into the task manager and it will even help you to assign tasks to people, etc. So you have to do it in a certain format, yeah.
And then you could probably try it also?
Oh yes, oh yes. Oh yes, I think there is a connector with Asana also, but that is a topic for another discussion, I guess, because that is it's really huge.
Yeah. Just wanted to know whether
there yeah, it is available. It is available.
Because these resources they seem humongous. I mean, once these are available,
yeah.
For anybody to use.
Yeah, yeah. In your company also, suppose you have minutes of the meetings, you want to share it with 10 people, definitely you should be able.
A lot of sense.
Yeah, yeah. And everything is residing here. That is the best part of it.
Yep.
So we can have question answer later on. Thank you, sir, for an amazing, wonderful power pack presentation. We never knew Evernote could be something like this. May I call Chetan on stage, please? Chetan, can you please present a token of appreciation to sir?
Only your notebooks.
Chetan sir.
Guys.
Thank you. Thank you.